Felix Kaur has been an NHS nurse for 30 years. Now, he's fighting for his life.
He loved nursing and he loved people. He'd used the skill and the knowledge and his own personality to make other people's lives better. And he was always so happy when he felt he'd done a good job.
Felix was on the COVID front line. He worked in A&E. The hospital says all staff had enough protection, but Felix didn't feel safe.
He was angry because he'd been issued with two paper masks for a 12-hour shift. And he said, that's not enough. I want a separate mask for every patient I go into.
Felix caught the virus last month. He's now on a ventilator in the hospital where he worked.
People shouldn't go into work and become ill and be damaged, and that's what's happened to Felix.
For weeks, the government has been dealing with criticism about stocks of personal protective equipment, or PPE. It says it's delivered 1 billion items. But we've obtained documents from inside the supply chain that show the reality of what's been delivered in the past couple of months. They show that the government is counting items you might not think of as PPE, such as cleaning equipment, waste bags, detergent, and paper towels. More than half the items are surgical gloves, and in most cases, each individual glove is counted rather than pairs. The second biggest item is plastic aprons that offer limited protection. The documents show how much PPE has been sent to each hospital trust in England.
I can see here the hospital trust in Southend. That's where Felix, the nurse who got COVID, that's where he worked. This column shows the number of gowns that have been delivered that the NHS staff need to wear.
In the 5 weeks before Felix was hospitalised, the government delivered 360 gowns across the whole Mid and South Essex Trust. That's just 10 a day. They had to buy more from other suppliers. This is the life-saving equipment we're talking about. The World Health Organization said healthcare workers caring for COVID patients should wear a gown, gloves, face mask, and eye protection.
These are some visors that have been made on home-bought 3D printers. St Thomas Community have been making these for us, and they're quite nice. Because you can actually see out of them.
And the patient can see you, so
yes,
there's...
But this is what some of our NHS staff have been wearing.
But the most perfect thing is a tight-fitting goggle, because then the virus can't get through. Also, this is a science lab glasses, which isn't brilliant, because, again, you can get the...
Get underneath. But is that what some of the staff are wearing, though?
Yeah. We've had local people drop these off for me.
Wow.
Somebody who's doing some building work.
This is all stuff that's just been dropped
off
here.
Libby Nolan is a senior nurse. She thought COVID was going to kill her.
My registrar became unwell, and I became unwell, and a few others within the team have become unwell. I had some very bleak hours. I don't want anyone to suffer this.
The Welsh Government says more than 1 million pieces of PPE have been given to Libby's hospital. But she thinks she was exposed because she didn't have the right kit.
What was it like? What was the worst part?
You can't get air in. Very, very constricted, tight. It feels like you're breathing through a straw.
Why was that kit not good enough from your point of view?
Because there was no coverage. We had very simple aprons, very like the aprons you would serve food with. We had a mask, which was just a surgical mask.
Some doctors and nurses say they've been warned not to speak out about the crisis. But Libby is a union rep and thinks people should know what conditions are like.
Sorry, I feel incredibly passionate that no more people should suffer, that no more health workers should come to harm, or for some reason that they can't speak out, that I will do it for them.
Across the UK, images of doctors and nurses in homemade kit have been posted online. Aprons made from bin bags, plastic bags on heads, swimming goggles and other home-supplied eye protection. And this nurse was not impressed with the official kit he'd been supplied.
This is a box of masks that we've been using today. And you can see the white sticker saying 2019. So that's out of date. The sticker that they've covered up the out of date sticker with is out of date.
Of course, stocks of PPE vary across the country. But some doctors working with COVID patients have decided to speak out.
We've been put on the front line, to use government terminology, but without frontline protection.
Do you feel safe as you do your job?
We know that this virus can kill people. We have seen healthcare workers die from this virus. Obviously, there's concern among healthcare professionals and NHS workers and care workers about this virus. I think you'd be inhuman if you didn't have that concern.
Nearly 100 NHS workers have died from the virus so far. But did it have to be like this? A pandemic is not an unexpected event. For almost a decade, it's been designated the greatest threat to Britain. Our hospital workers should be kept safe. The government says it's been preparing for a pandemic for years. This is a public information film from 2006.
Pandemic flu is very infectious and may make a large number of people ill. And some people will die.
The government's plans were based on an outbreak of flu.
We need your help to create a united front against the virus. There are some things you must do to help slow its spread.
The government says COVID-19 is a different disease with a higher hospitalisation rate.
Wash your hands thoroughly and often.
But the advice and the PPE required are very similar for both diseases. To be ready for any pandemic, you need to stockpile, because once it hits, every country with the disease needs PPE.
This government pandemic guidance from 2009 gives a simple list of what is needed. A gown, the best type of face mask and eye protection.
John Ashton is a public health expert and long-standing critic of the government.
There's no excuse for not having adequate stockpiles. You need everything to protect against this kind of virus. It's breathtaking that there were no gowns at all in stock. Breathtaking.
And we've discovered it wasn't just gowns left off the shopping list. The government also failed to buy other essential items that would be needed in a pandemic.
The government didn't buy any visors at all. There were no swabs either, which makes testing for the virus more difficult. And the government didn't buy a single body bag, despite the fact they were supposed to be preparing for a pandemic.
And Panorama has discovered that millions of respirator masks are unaccounted for. 33 million were on the original stockpile shopping list, But only 12 million have been handed out, and the government refuses to explain where the other life-saving masks have gone.
The consequence of not planning, not ordering kit, not having stocks, not having stockpiles, is that we are sending in to the front line doctors, nurses, other health workers and social care workers without the equipment to keep them safe.
The government says swabs, body bags were not recommended by experts and that surgical gowns will be procured for inclusion in the future stockpile. For a decade, we failed to get the stockpile right, but when COVID-19 first appeared, we still had time. At the start of February, the European Centre of Disease Control issued a warning. They advised us what we needed to buy and how much. The document says we'll need respirator masks, eye protection, gowns and gloves. We should have been getting ready.
February is when we started seeing the big outbreaks in Europe. So actually, February was our month to prepare. These 4 weeks of February were crucial.
The government has been accused of failing to act quickly enough. Here's the kind of opportunity we missed. This factory in Bolton makes the protective fabric needed to make specialist PPE gowns and masks. But they weren't approached by the government in February. And in March, the company offered their services.
I've personally written to government myself, written to MPs, and we've also written to Public Health England. At this stage, we haven't really had a response.
We filmed 10 days after the company offered to help the UK, but they still hadn't heard back. This order is for the United States.
They failed to get a grip. They took advice from too narrow a range of people. And when things continued to escalate out of control, they started to spin the story to make out that actually they'd been following the science and everything that they did made perfect sense. I think it's disgraceful.
We're now a nation in lockdown. Our health service is at the heart of the nation's fight against the disease.
This public demonstration of support means such a lot to those who work in the NHS. But some of them worry that this outpouring of emotion helps the government gloss over the shortages that are on some of the wards. As one intensive care nurse said to us, calling us heroes just makes it okay when we die.
The government has consistently denied there's a shortage of PPE in the stockpile. It's blamed logistical problems and says it's built a whole new distribution network. The army has also been brought in to sort it out. We've spoken to a number of heads of procurement at NHS trusts. They didn't want to be identified, but say the supply chain still isn't working.
There is a complete lack of transparency from the government. They're creating panic, as we don't know if they can supply us, so we're scrambling to get it elsewhere.
We've been told not to talk about the shortages outside of meetings and calls. They don't want people to know how bad it is.
It's not just hospitals. GPs also need PPE. The World Health Organization says everyone dealing with COVID patients should have the full kit.
The supplies that were given were very limited. We've not been able to rely upon the supply chain of the NHS.
So here they've bought their own PPE. This surgery on Merseyside is in a COVID hotspot.
You've got to bring your office here, Okay, you look tired. When have you started to get more short of breath?
On Friday.
Okay, fine.
But the last 2 days have been a lot worse.
Right. I think we would have to assume you've got coronavirus.
What happens now then?
I think we are best off transferring you up to Arrow.
Didn't really
want to
go anywhere near
you. You're going to need things like a chest x-ray and that kind of thing. Unfortunately, with this being a primary care hub, it's not available in
The government says health workers in a GP surgery only need a plastic apron and a basic surgical mask. But doctors here don't believe that.
People in healthcare losing their lives and being put at risk is something that keeps me awake every night. I wouldn't be prepared to work without an appropriate mask, face shield, and a gown to treat people who are suspected of COVID or who have been diagnosed with COVID. And I wouldn't ask my staff to do that.
We've investigated the government guidance telling NHS staff what PPE they should wear. It seems clear that rules have been changed because of the shortages. In January, the government designated COVID-19 as what's called a high consequence infectious disease. The Health and Safety Executive had already investigated what PPE was needed when tackling a high consequence infectious disease. It concluded all staff should wear a respirator face mask, full face visor, and a gown. And the government has a legal obligation to make sure NHS staff have the right kit.
But 6 weeks ago, the government downgraded COVID-19. The most consequential disease of the last 100 years was taken off the list of the highly consequential infectious diseases. Should COVID-19 be on that list?
COVID-19 is the biggest infectious disease to hit this country in the last 100 years. Why on earth shouldn't it be in the most serious category of classification?
The official reason for the downgrading was that there was now a lab test for the virus and COVID-19's mortality rate was low overall. The government told us scientific evidence evolves and plans are adapted accordingly.
Yeah, do you want to drop and don and come in?
Removing the disease from the list was backed by a scientific committee. But sources on that committee have told Panorama that it had to be, in part, a pragmatic decision based on the availability of PPE. That is certainly the view of some on the ward. Staff think the guidelines are not about keeping them safe, but making do with a shortage of PPE.
I love the NHS and I'm proud of it and I'm so proud to be part of it, but I feel so ashamed by how the NHS has been treated, that we've been expected to battle this pandemic, but we've just not been looked after at all.
So many NHS staff have already died while trying to protect us from the disease. COVID-19 will be with us for months. How many lives will be lost because of the scandalous shortage of PPE?